Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, everybody. Come to the words of our first song that our God is not made by human hands. Hallelujah. The book of Samuel writes about Israel going into battle with the Philistines. And Israel being slaughtered by the Philistines, then the Philistines took the ark of the Lord and placed it in the house of Dagon, their idol God. Amen. The Philistines, waking up in the morning, found Dagon was fallen flat on his face to the earth before the ark of the Lord. What a great God we serve, amen? Because scripture tells us that every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord of all. Hallelujah. Let us humble ourselves and let us pray.
Lord Jesus, we humble kneel before you because you are great in all the earth. There is none like you, Lord. You reign from everlasting to everlasting. Thou art righteous, thou art kind, thou art wonderful. We worship you and adore you.
Lord, we confess that we have sinned in words and thoughts and in deeds. Many times we fall short of your glory. Search us, O Lord, if there be any unrighteousness, any unforgiveness, any unfaithfulness, any unholiness, Lord. We ask that thou may cleanse us with your blood. In Jesus' name, we thank you for your presence, we thank you for your anointing, and we thank you for your Holy Ghost power that lives in us. In Jesus' name, all God's people say.
Praise the Lord, Tato Katotua. Praise the Lord, saints. Praise the Lord, all of us here in the house of God, and for those of us joining us by this live stream service from your homes around Rarotonga and around the country. A thought just came to my mind with this COVID, how COVID has silenced our lips and prohibits us from singing his praise this morning. Our hearts belong to God and the devil can't touch that. So out of our hearts this morning, saints, let us sing the loudest song to praise his name this morning. For our families and friends who are covered with sickness, with ailments, who are restricted to be mobile this morning, we welcome you into the house of the Lord by way of this live stream. Kia ora ana tātou katoa e te istangata te taihake, e noo maire ki tō tātou ngutuare, te tapuki ia, e te tumurangi kirikere i te angara, tō tātou kōpū tangata e noo maire ki te oere ko ararangi puaikura. Kia ora ana kōtou katoa e te aroa maana o tō tātou atu. To our friends and families on the island of Manihiki, remember our sister Mihau and your family. We praise the Lord that you've been able to make it home to rest. We join you this morning as we celebrate the name of our Lord and Christ Jesus. As Bishop has just reminded us, our COVID restrictions, please keep your seats distance. If you are at home, also keep distance from your neighbors. But least of all, do not distance yourself from God, because he's got the answer to everything we need. Praise the Lord, saints, and let us start our worship and praise his holy name this morning. We are going to start with our Sunday school. There will be some changes you will see in our presentations this morning. Our music is sung by a choir we'll be missing this morning, but it doesn't stop us from praising his name with alternate means. To start our Sunday school service this morning, we will welcome our group from Deacon Stephen from Avatu Valley.
I promised him I would serve him until I die.
Straight up, come straight up. Come.
When
your name is called,
my
just come
heart ain't say pain. Sunshine and rain, but I'm fighting, yes I am.
Fighting for the Lord.
Listen, I get up and I get down, but I never turn around.
I'm fighting
for
the Lord. I'm
fighting for the Lord.
I'm fighting for the Lord.
Sure.
Apostle James.
Come straight up. Come up.
Come straight up.
Yes,
we also have Apostle Matthew beyond the reading.
Lydia calls to serve, Acts 16:15, and when she was baptized, and her household, she was sold as slave.
Oh. Rarotonga! And they had a year and a half together before Paul left them. Aquila and Priscilla in turn were able to carry on the ministry in Ephesus and were also able to mentor others. Instrumental in the ministry, Priscilla and Aquila together were able to appreciate one another, sharing the ministry. They had one focus, and Priscilla called to minister. Possibly she was a bit more charismatic than Aquila. However, and whatever the reason Priscilla was called to minister, we too must be ready to serve in whatsoever capacity God will call us into. And today, our last lesson in our study, the call of women. Today's lesson, Lydia, called to serve. The Apostle Paul, Silas, Timothy, and Luke also joined them. They had been visiting a few churches and fellowships and were planning to go to a certain area, but the Holy Ghost stopped them. Important to follow the Holy Ghost leading and to follow the will of God. Then we will always be successful and bring God glory. The missionary team was traveling through Macedonia and to sail to the chief city, Philippi, where our lesson takes place today. The ministry at Philippi. Acts 16, verses 11 through 13. Therefore, loosing from Troas and came straight from, and the next day to Neapolis, and thence to Philippi, which is the chief city to that part of Macedonia, and a colony. And we were in the city abiding certain days. And on the Sabbath, we went out to the city by a riverside where prayer was wont to be made. And we sat down and spake unto the women which resorted hither. This is a Roman colony, mostly Roman citizens in this area. Paul and his companions usually have someone as a contact in the area, usually where they're going to travel to. In this case, they know no one. In Philippi, there are not 10 Jewish men to convene and to lead a synagogue. And today is the Sabbath. They hear that there is a group that prays down by the river, and they join this woman prayer group and encourage them to continue to pray and worship. God, hallelujah. They continue to preach Christ, who showed no favoritism. And the women that had converted to Christ have become a major source in building up the spread of the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. The conversion of Lydia in Acts 16, 14 through 15 and verse 40. And a certain woman called Lydia, a seller of purple in the city of Thyatira, which worshiped God, heard us, whose heart the Lord had opened, that she attended unto the things which were spoken of Paul. And when she was baptized and her household, she besought us, saying, if ye have judged me to be faithful to the Lord, come into my house and abide there. And she constrained us. Hallelujah. And verse 40, Paul and Silas had been in prison, and they were come out of prison, verse 40 says, and they entered in the house of Lydia. And when they had seen the brethren, they comforted them and departed. Lydia, her heart is ready to receive God's word. She listens intently and accepts the truth of the preaching and the teaching. Lydia is the first convert in Europe, and after receiving Christ for herself, she is baptized and also her household baptized. Lydia invites Paul and his team to stay at her home. She insists and persuaded them to stay in turn. They had more time with them to receive more preaching and teaching and help birth and to bless this new Christian community. The wisdom of the cross in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 26 through 28. For ye see your calling, brethren, that how not many wise men after the flesh, not many mighty, not many noble are called. But God had chosen the foolish things of the world to confound the wise, and God had chosen the weak things of the world to confound the things which are mighty. The base things of the world and the things which are despised hath God chosen, yea, the things which are not, to bring to naught things that are. God caused people to spread the word of God, many of whom society has overlooked. God calls those that have resources and wealth, and he calls the poor and the less fortunate. Most early converts were working class people, and many were poor. The Apostle Paul is saying to the church, as one of our home groups brought out in the lesson, Apostle Paul is saying to the church, formal education, political power, hallelujah, and economic class and status are not what puts you ahead in the kingdom of God. God specifically calls those the world has cast off and counts as low to show his glory. The benefits of the cross is 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 29 and 30, which finishes up our lesson for today. God's purpose in selecting the lowly to be his servants helps us to remember that it is God who has given all things to us. Our blessings, our life, our everything comes from him. And we know that he is our source, and it is God who allows us to prosper, and only he deserves our praise. It is God and God alone. We are in Christ, and God has placed us in Christ, and Jesus is our only source for wisdom, sanctification, righteousness, redemption. Jesus did all the work of our salvation. Our boast is in Christ alone to bring us back into a rich relationship and a more abundant life in Christ Jesus. What is the lesson for us today? Lydia was called to serve. She had the resources, and she was very generous in showing hospitality to the Apostle Paul and his team. And it is a part of our call as a saint to show hospitality and meet the needs of others as the Lord leads us. Lydia had not only wealth and a business, she was a woman of influence to her family and her workers. Her whole household was converted and saved. We should also be a people of influence also, not just let people within our circle or family or community continue without sharing Jesus. Jesus is our source of all things. All deserves all the glory for whatever we accomplish in life. It's not about you, hallelujah. Our source of wisdom, righteousness, sanctification, our redemption, our salvation, all we need is found in Christ alone. Lydia was called to serve, and so are we. Whatever capacity we serve, let it be all for the glory of God. I want to share this piece of a post that I came across. The call of women in the ministry and early church. Being a woman in the Bible time, biblical times, was not easy. In fact, biblical times teaching a woman was taught to read, it was even illegal. Women were viewed as property. Women were excluded from the inner courts of the temple, and men did not speak to their wives in public. And yet Mary, remember Mary at Jesus' feet? And one occasion, she raised her hand and was asking questions. And everybody, especially Martha, her sister, is thinking, Mary ought to be in the kitchen with me, helping me. Finally, Martha reaches her limit and decides to call her out. Martha's indignation was perfectly understandable in the light of her culture. A Jewish woman's primary role was that of a homemaker. She was exempt from rabbinic training and received no merit from learning the law. So should Martha's request that Mary help her in service supersede Mary's desire to learn? Well, Jesus didn't think so. He said Mary had chosen the good part. Mary's choice was revolutionary and in turn highlighted the revolutionary impact of Jesus on the world at that time. Praise the Lord, saints. In Mary's day, learning in general, let alone at the feet of a renowned teacher or rabbi, was a privilege reserved only for men. However, to further understand the stark departure from the norm, and we know about the norm, there's a new norm, right? Hallelujah. So Jesus was one that went outside the box. Hallelujah. And we appreciate the phrase, at Jesus' feet. It says in here, a technical way of identifying an active and accepted disciple. It is clear that this is more than a posture of worship. Luke's picture of Mary sitting at Jesus' feet in the posture of a disciple has been called perhaps the strongest and clearest affirmation on the part of Jesus that the intellectual and spiritual life just as proper to women as to men. That was radical. Jesus wasn't concerned about the culture. Hallelujah, and neither should we. With the approval of Jesus, it appears that Mary had broken free momentarily from her socially mandated role by leaving her domestic duties to sit at the feet of Jesus and receive instruction. Female discipleship was openly sanctioned by Jesus in this instant. And while Mary's decision was unquestionably challenging, we learned from Jesus that such decisions will be judged by Jesus as that good part. Jesus changed the world for women and gave them new purposes. They were a regular part of Jesus' community. This is no doubt why women were drawn to the New Testament church. Women flocked to the early church because Jesus was a safe place for women. He still is. He showed them respect and dignity and valued their intellect and their gifts. After the death and resurrection of Jesus, women continued to play prominent roles in the early movement. Some scholars have suggested that the majority of Christians in the first century church may have been women. Women were the first one at the cradle, and the last at the cross, the first at the resurrection, and they were there at Pentecost. Hallelujah. Jesus defied the culture of his day, including and valuing women. His attitude and acts of honoring and inclusively rocked the world at the time. Mary was one of the first to catch on, and the whole world is still trying to catch up. When men honor women, they model Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank God for our Sunday school lessons. These five lessons, women called in ministry, have been a blessing for me. I don't know about the other sisters in the church, but it's been a blessing to me. I am encouraged as a woman to serve and to be an influencer for Jesus with God's help. And our next 13 lessons are about men, the prophets of God. So stay tuned for these beautiful lessons coming up. Hallelujah. May God bless us and our beautiful Cook Island.
Thank you, Mama. Can I just ask everyone in this in the house of God, especially the men, boys, let's stand up and give the message a big, resounding round of applause. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Mama, my sincerest apologies for pushing the program a little bit faster than you were expecting, but that message is so powerful, we needed to get it done. But now, the results of our Sunday school to end it all this morning. As we saw last week, everyone was in the exceptional categories. Today, we have slipped a little bit. In the better category, we have James, Paul, Bartholomew. And in the outstanding category, we have Tony, Stephen, Matthew, Mark, Peter, Jude, Andrew, the Tonga, and the Samoa community. We missed the mark with the exceptional. But nevertheless, let us give and thank God for our Sunday school lessons today. My pleasure now to introduce to you our bishop.
Before, let me just continue on where Mama left. Hallelujah. Our scripture for Sunday school, what does it say? And when she was baptized and her household, she besought us, saying, if we have judged me to be faithful to the Lord, come into my house and abide there. And she constrained us, hallelujah, when she was baptized. That's when she began in the church, when she was baptized. Not just joined, not just welcomed and invited, and think you're a member of that body. She was baptized. Hallelujah. And a second important word there is faithful. If you think I'm faithful for this ministry, come into my house. Hallelujah. Very powerful. Can we go to Acts 2:42, 41 rather? Thank you, Jesus. Now back to the early church. The beginning of the church of Jesus Christ after Peter opened the door to the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. To you, Peter, I give the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. That was the key that he opened to the kingdom on the day of Pentecost. At his first preaching. Hallelujah. 41, altogether 1-2. Then they that gladly received his word were baptized. Peter, the leader of the apostles and the believers, 120 altogether, from the upper room, first filled with the Holy Ghost. They that gladly received his message were baptized. First thing was baptized. And the same day, there was added unto them about 3,000 souls. The beginning of the church of Jesus Christ. Ancient Judaism was still there. They still kept what they believed in. Jesus established and started. Now, this faith going beyond the Jewish circle, outside the box, to include us, to make this apostolic ministry inclusive. No more excluding women. No more excluding Gentiles. No more excluding the black from the white, no more excluding the poor from the rich, no more excluding the disabled from the able. In Christ Jesus, there is no discrimination. There is no segregation. There is no relegation. There is no in and out. All are one in Christ. For by one Spirit have we been baptized into one body and made to drink of the one Spirit, the Spirit of Jesus Christ. That's the church of Jesus Christ. Can we say amen? But when we go overseas, it's a very tough task for me as the diocesan to encourage our churches there. There is no Cook Island church in the kingdom. You have to bring in the whites. You have to bring in the whatever color. You have to get all other ethnicities to be the church. No such thing as a one color church and a one class church and a one gender, a one status church. All being baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Born free, men, women, Greek, Gentile, and Jew. Made one in Christ Jesus. So I thank God for this beautiful lesson that Mama brought us through, and each and every elder who taught us in our several home groups. And today is the last presentation of that series. As Mama said, we move on to the men and see what they can do. Hallelujah. Can we say amen? Give one more big hand of praise to God. Thank you. Thank you, Mama. Thank you, Elder.
Praise the Lord, everybody. It's a birthday celebration time. If you have turned of age from Monday to today, please come forward and testify what the Lord has done. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It appears we don't have any celebration. Let us move on to our tithes and offering with Elder Joseph.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let me ask some of the elders, the ministers, come get the basket. Hallelujah. At the door. They'll come through and collection and to these on the stage. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you.
Praise the Lord, saints. It's giving time. Hallelujah. Let us be upstanding. So they were all baptized in the name of Jesus. And our tithing message also says, bring ye all the tithes. All. Don't leave what belongs to God to you. Hallelujah. So bring all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in mine house, and prove me now. Here will say the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out the blessings, that there shall be not room enough to receive it. So come and give to bless the ministry of God.
I want you to be true to who you are.
I made up and I won't turn back, 'cause I want to see my Jesus someday. Goodbye world, I stand no longer with you. Goodbye pleasures of sin, I stand no longer with you. I made up my mind to go my way.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for the giving hearts of your people. Continue to bless our hearts, Lord, to give freely and cheerfully to bless the work of your ministry. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for another beautiful day, the sweet breath of life freely given with no limits. Thank you, Lord, for your most precious blood, unwavering grace and love. Thank you for blessing us with a COVID-free country, Lord. May we continue to serve you wholeheartedly with praises and with unwavering love too. Dear Lord Jesus, we pray and uphold our nation, our leaders in government, and leaders of all walks of life. Strengthen each one and empower them, Lord, according to your riches and glory, so that together as one, we may show forth the beautiful fruit of the Spirit and be endowed with steadfasting patience, wisdom, and love. Praying for the lost, the hurt, the sick, the bereaved, and those imprisoned behind both visible and invisible walls here in our nation and the world at large. Send your divine healing, Lord, comfort, peace, and love to all and even to those who claim there's no more hope. Lord, bless our leaders and frontline workers nowadays to make the best decisions and as they work tirelessly to keep the unwanted mucky out, Lord Jesus. Bless our people too to unite and work together for the good of our nation. And above all, Lord Jesus, as your word always reminds us, if my people which are called by my name shall humble themselves, pray and seek my face in turn, and turn away from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will heal their lands. Lord Jesus, your will be done. In your wonderful name, Jesus. Amen.
Yang anga po pinga kore ta tano ngai patun. Ke kore yo va cheki to ire. Yara anga po pinga kore ta tano ngai chek. Ori te tu te pu bot ne ma tu te tu. I te secretary ta marai ora Bob Williams. Te ta te te ne chi te tu. Te wora anga anga ka to te marai ora te tu. E ra vene te tu te anga te tu. Te tu no te paruru I to ma to ora anga ko pa te tu. Ora ngai ra to te tu te maruru. Orang kira tu tikit, tengah aku aku korang makit itu, itu tawin yang ada itu, itu matu, itu tangat. Tengah tu 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 aku mata kita itu, tu tu ini kita matu, matu itu itu tangat aku kira ni itu, kita kau lah orang matu itu, itu lo ikut kita itu. Tengah orang orang itu marah orang, orang tahu tu rumah yang matu itu, itu tangat aku kira ni itu. Thank you itu, no tahu apa awi diringi, kita ngah itu, tenu itu. Ko koe pau mai nei, ko koe akolongo mai nei, I tā mātou pure te tua. Kia ka mete ki e, kia ka pāpā ia koe te tua. Te pure katoa nei mātou te tua, no te ia maki tinki, ia ka mata nei te tua. Te pure nei mātou I roto I te ngō mana, o Jesu Mesia te tua. Kia rapakau koe te tua, I te ia maki te tua. Mātou tōu nei te tangata te tua, kia ka rongo I te ututua te tua. Te pure nei mātou, no te ia nei au kātotoa. Te nā teo mana manata, teo tūmata te ngā te tua. E tai ua mātou te tua e pure ki a koe te tua. Te pure nei mātou te pati roto, e te ngua mana o Jesu Mesia. Kia anganga koe te tua, kia tauturu te tua. Tōna iti tangata tapu Israele te tua. Te pure nei mātou no te au e Rūsarema, aka metake mai e rātou kātotoa te tua. Nore ko tā mātou te e pure nei pati nei, roto rawa te ngua mana o Jesu mātou e pure I. Amene.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Tatokatoto. Praise the Lord, saints. It's church notices time. Amen. Just recapping on what the bishop had already said, we're having fellowship luncheon after our service. You can have it a takeaway or eat here. For those eating here, please give seating priority to our seasoned folks, should any of them want to stay. Amen. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. Aye, and should the seasoned folks decide to go home, then, amen. Hallelujah, but please, at the Ministry of Health, amen. Apostles Peter, Paul, Andrew, and Matthew, who you will be responsible for the serving of our lunch, as well as the cleaning of the dishes after lunch. But we can and we will lend a hand. Praise the Lord, saints. Amen. Elder Joseph has confirmed that there's no prison visit this afternoon until further notice. And it looks like everybody will be at home this afternoon. So why not turn your TV on at 4 p.m. and watch our Nothing But the Truth ministry. And lastly, saints, there's a bottle of hand sanitizer on the table in the fellowship hall, please use it as much as you can. Amen. Use it all the time. Hallelujah. And tonight's service is at 6:30 p.m. Come ready to tell everybody of the Lord's blessings on your life. So in other words, come prepared with a testimony. Those on duty tonight have already been sent out on the loop. Amen. And tonight is also our bishop's teaching night. So come ready to be filled spiritually. Hallelujah. These are our notices. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. At this time, I have the pleasure to call upon the following elders, Adiru and William. Hallelujah. Take your oil and anoint the work that you've done out there. Hallelujah. And for you and Nebia, anoint the room, hallelujah, for the RAC board meeting, hallelujah. Fafoy, hallelujah, and Elder John, anoint the rail that you made, hallelujah, for the catering service out there, hallelujah, glory to God. And Tony, where are you, Tony? Tony, I'm counting the money, hallelujah. Narang, bye. My God, Elder Rose, hallelujah. Go anoint all the aircon. One aircon over there, and inside, outside the secretary's office, hallelujah, and the bishop's office, hallelujah. Okay, go pray, anoint them, and come in, hallelujah. While they're doing that, I'd like to bring this news out from Tuvalu. Thank you, Jess. Can you put that up? She'll bring up a photo of a new church built, enlarged in the Kiribati Islands. Some already seen it on the loop, others are not on the loop. Hallelujah. 2019, Mama and I were in, together with the Tachiras in Tuvalu, and commissioned these two missionaries and their wives and their families. Hallelujah. One is Achu, named Achu, the older man, and the younger one is John. Hallelujah. And they are both local builders. Is that as large as we can make? Beautiful, on the floor with the lino and plaited flex. Kuyoki Ro, Ade Ro. They only went there 2019. 2020, they started building. And there we have the new church there. I wish you could bring it larger. And, they just completed. This is our dear pastor in Tuvalu. Kisona, Tafiti Kisona, they just completed the church building in Kiribati, Whakawhitai Lasi, to the SPDC mission for all the support. May the Lord be with us all in Jesus' name. Can we say amen? Amen. Hallelujah. You build this church. Hallelujah. And all others on the mission field by your support of mission. Hallelujah. If you're not supporting mission, then you're not counted. Except you've been baptized. Amen. Baptized means inclusive, not exclusive. In the name of Jesus, and supposed to have the Holy Ghost. And here's the latest notice from our dear pastor in Tuvalu. Our missionaries to Toma, Elder Taustasi and Sister Vika, are now in Fiji for studying. I commissioned them to Toma at the time. This opportunity didn't open up because she was a daycare preschool teacher. So Sister Vika was selected by the government to do her degree as a teacher for preschool. So the whole family was sponsored by government. Hallelujah. Take it out of Tuvalu. I left some mission money to put them on the boat. Hallelujah. To sail when things open up. Now government has come in and taken them to Fiji. So they are trying. Hallelujah. So the whole family was sponsored by government for 3 years course. Thank you, Jesus. Sponsored funded. They are trying their very best to organize someone to look after their little girls so Elder Tautasi can go to Tonga to start the mission. At this time, the school hasn't started yet. They already the fellowship with other family in Suva. They've already rallied a little group in Suva. Our missionary in Kiribati passed me his regards to you, Bishop, and to the entire SPDC. He was so thankful for all the supports from you, sir. He told me in every Sunday morning he fellowshiped with the saints in Bonriki, but in the afternoon with the saints in Taborio, two places they go have church just to cater and accommodate the need of those people in those islands. Hallelujah. They do their Sunday school after the main service. I always send him a copy of our Sunday school lesson every week. Our mission here in Tuvalu this year, their theme is Eyes Front for Jesus. Hebrews 2:2. Look unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. That is powerful. Enduring the shame. Hallelujah. Amen. I challenge the Akararamanitato. Our mission this year is the outreach house to house every Tuesday night and do prayer meeting in five groups. One of the group are all youth led by Mother Millie and myself. This Sunday, the youth will visit the prison from 4 o'clock to 5 o'clock. Our church building project still in progress. Probably the building, the build plan will be ready by the end of next month. Whakawhitai lasi lasi, meaning big, big, ma'ata. Beitake ma'ata ma'ata uatue. Whakawhitai lasi lasi, Bishop. Alofa to the first family. Manui tatu it alofa o Yesu. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. At this time, I have the pleasure and honor. I've waited for this opportunity. Hallelujah. This is a divine visitation and divine providence. Two of our son and daughter, hallelujah, were working in the Solomon Islands. Hallelujah. For the ministries there. And he will explain to us. But somehow, the devil, all sicknesses, all death is of the devil. God is a God of the living, not of the dead. Death is not of God. Because man disobeyed God, they brought sin upon their lives, and sin is death. The penalty of sin is death. Hallelujah. Otherwise, we wouldn't have died if it wasn't for it. We wouldn't have had any sickness if it wasn't for it. Hallelujah. God is light, in him is no darkness at all. Thank you, Jesus. And so, our dear brother Peter got struck down. He had to be flown on an air ambulance, hallelujah, all the way to New Zealand. And thank you, Jesus, I was there, I visited, I saw the seriousness of it. And today, I saw the hand of God upon him. He wouldn't have lived and survived to this day. Hallelujah. To receive his salvation, his Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. And his future leadership in Jesus. Hallelujah. Only because of Jesus by the grace. So while he had to be flown, not to Australia, but all the way to New Zealand for some reason, under certain circumstances, the wife all alone by herself was making her way the other way. Other route through Fiji, just to make it to New Zealand before he arrived or to meet up. Yeah, it was one time we were requested chain prayer. Hallelujah, for them. Thank you, Jesus. Before they come up, I'd like to invite our dear Mama Minya from Tonga. Hallelujah, to come and testify. Hallelujah. Let's hear her personal testimony. It's another blessing that the Lord has brought this sister, and she's been looking for the church as the Lord led and directed and guided her. She ended up here. Hallelujah. She has just as much right as you have, because we all were baptized in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lydia. Be blessed by our dear sister from Tonga. Hallelujah. To testify. Thank you.
Thank you, Bishop, for the blessing. Tulo, Olomai. Maloe Lele, Prophet Taike Eiki. My name is Mele Minia Batuei. I am from the Kingdom of Tonga, but my citizenship is the Kingdom of God. Praise God. What's the biggest challenge of my life? My choice to come here to Rarotonga. I step out of my comfort zone, away from my family, friends, everything I used to. Once I got here, we had the lockdown because of COVID-19. And I know right away it's gonna be a long, long time before I can see my loved ones again. Months passed by, I started to miss my family, feel so homesick and so lonely. I felt something so missing in my life. There is a big emptiness inside me. I knew then that my spiritual life is so low and it's like freezing, because I was too focused on myself, feel so sorry for myself, instead of having my relationship with God, it was so lack. I didn't have time to read my Bible. So I went to a few churches here in Rarotonga, try somewhere to help me comfort the loneliness. On the 22nd of July 2010, I visited Apostolic Church, this church. Right away when I walked in that door, I felt so at home. I felt so completed. Right at the back, I was sitting there when the worship team doing their praise and worship. I said, Jesus, thank you for your answering my prayer. And I believe that he said, I will never leave or forsake you wherever you are. I felt I'm at the right place on the right time. On this 26th July last year, I thanked Bishop. I went through water baptism, but the most joyful blessing for me that I enjoyed, the first time to experience filled with the Holy Spirit. Something I've been reading about on the Bible how many times, but I never believed I can experience it. What spiritual growth and joy I got from since I came to Apostolic Church. First, my spiritual relationship with God is growing. Second, I found inner peace here in Rarotonga. I don't miss my family much anymore. They have to check with me if I'm still alive or not. I told them I have my family in Apostolic. Third, I find joy in doing, helping whatever little things I can do for the church to serve and to save souls for the Kingdom of God, helping Bishop. The fourth, I practice my faith, especially this time of the COVID, that we so dwell and focus on COVID-19 and we forgot that we have to more me, myself, spend more time with the Word of God and pray more time for safety. I thank the Lord for taking me to Nikau Chon Apostolic Church, that how God planned my life that he will take me where he knows I'll be fit in well. What I got out of my home crew, I experienced the joy of practicing our Sunday school activities through learning my memory verses every week, 4 weeks a month. That's, I got 4 memory verses a week. Not only that, I learned it both in Tongan and English. First, I was so struggling, I don't want to come to church anymore. But now, I thank the Lord. I practice both my memory verses in my language, also in English. Second to it, I love the fellowship with my families on my home group. I thank to my eldest and my intern eldest and my brothers and sisters in my home group. I feel at home. I felt the unity, the caring, the fellowship, and the sharing. And I feel at home. I am blessed with teaching every time. Our First Lady, Mama Bear, that's the first thing that attracted me when I came to Apostolic, is your sum up, the Sunday school. It has really, really helped me a lot with my daily walking with God. Thank you, Mama. I thank the Lord for the man of God, Bishop Bele, for every teaching and every God time I just have you and me, and sharing, and you're encouraging me. The first a verse that really touched me every time you repeat all the time is Act 2:38. I went through repent, but I never know that three are one. You have to go through repenting. You must go through baptized in the name of Jesus. And you must be filled up with the Holy Ghost. That's the only way you can find strength and encouraging to do God's work. Lastly, I found in Christ the most thing is inner peace and the joy of coming and help the church, whatever little thing, if that's all I can do, Bishop, is testimony, to help with your serving and your passion to save more souls for the kingdom of God, that's all I can do. Yes, Philippians 4, verse 4. Let's rejoice in the Lord always. How can I say? Let's rejoice. Amen.
Thank you, Sister Lydia. Hallelujah. Thank you for the correction. I learned something from you too, because I've always referred to you, Mama Minya, Mama Minya, Mama Minya, until you corrected me. I'm not a mama, I'm still a girl. Hallelujah. So Mama in Tonga is very old woman. Hallelujah. I'm not an old woman. I'm a young woman. Hallelujah. So call me sister. Thank you. I'm not married yet. I'm still waiting on the Lord to bless me. Thank you. So don't worry about tough enough to learn English and Tonga. You can add number 3, Cook Island. That makes 3. 3-in-1, Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, Peter was expecting a long distance consultation with big businesses overseas. So he did ask me if he's called for that. Just understand that he's not at church but on Zoom, because today is Monday overseas. Hallelujah. It's Sunday for us. That's when they work business as usual. But by God's own divine providence, they are here. However, you can organize yourself. You start or she starts. Put our hands together and welcome Brother Peter. And my name. Be blessed by it. Hallelujah. I see too many movement back there. Those young children back there should be up front. So you keep an eye on them. Anybody with on the Zoom, cut it off. I need to bring the mobile to me. I'll make money out of it. You don't go Wanda and Coca on your mobile. Cut it off. Thank you, Jesus. You're here for Jesus. Focus to Jesus. Otherwise, you come empty, you go empty, and the devil is waiting on you. Amen. Thank you, Peter.
Thank you, Bishop. It's a little bit hard to come and speak after the presentations that we've had today. I'm not going to be able to get to the level that's already been set. If I had my choice, I would have come first, set the standard down, and then they can bring it up after. So I do apologize if I can't get to the standard that our mother did with our summary of Sunday school and what the sister Minia has just provided. But what I will try to do is give you an idea. I probably won't be able to live up to the praise that the bishop has given me, but I'll certainly try my best. And I'm also reminded when I by my sister Tere when I came this morning. She said, just have faith. And throughout presentations and discussions this morning, that word faith has come forward. So first of all, kia ora ana, praise the Lord, tato. Please don't expect any words of wisdom. I'm just a new kid on the block. I'm still learning. But I am privileged to stand before you this morning just to provide a short testimony. It will be short. Events that have happened to me and led up to something that has really changed. I'm truly grateful and praise God for all his blessings. I definitely did not deserve any, but I'm still truly grateful. The short testimony is about what I believe to be God's work, and it's important that you listen to the points that I highlight. As they say, God works in mysterious ways. I've only just started to understand or be able to unravel the meaning of those words. Yet it's something that Papa OJ drummed into us 35 years ago. Of course, I was always studying a turi, and you'll see later on, and didn't listen. So I'm 35 years late, but I'm happy that I'm here now. I was diagnosed with a broken heart, or as the doctors called it, severe aortic stenosis. This is where the aortic valve at the top of the heart wasn't contracting properly, and thereby reducing the blood circulation, because there was no power for the heart to push the blood around the body. I was referred to New Zealand for treatment in early 2011. It was a condition that had been with me since contracting bronchitis when I was just a little kid, way back in the days when, if you know where the health admin is today, that's where the hospital was. Apologize to the younger generators, you wouldn't have known that. I didn't actually know I had this this condition, but it was with me. Probably why I couldn't work out why I kept getting tired trying to play rugby. Anyway, I arrived in New Zealand in January 2011, but it wasn't until October that year that I underwent heart surgery to mend my broken heart. They replaced the aortic valve with a bionic one. This is a little mechanical device that acts to shut and open the heart so that it can fill with blood and then push it around the body. Circulation to those that are educated. Of course, this bionic valve made me feel a lot younger. My mind would run around the corner, but then have to wait for the body to catch up. With a new valve, I'm also required to take warfarin tablets. And there's a lot of people out there that also have heart conditions that are required to take warfarin tablets. The warfarin prevents the blood from clotting. It also, with the warfarin, will prevent the jamming of the mechanics of my valve, causing my heart not to stop pumping. Because we all know, if the heart starts pumping, game's over. Fast forward 2013, April, I was fortunate enough to be offered a job at the Pacific Island Foreign Fisheries Agency as a monitoring control surveillance policy advisor in the Solomon Islands. We were based in Honiara. Honiara is a nice place. It's a great place for bodybuilding, as you can see from this sculpture. There was plenty of fish. There's no cigatera. They've got plenty of vegetables. There's also about the same amount of rice to go with it. We had it good. Piara was with us. We had it good. Pay, of course, was really good. Breakfast, Saturdays, Sundays, we would always eat out. It was always my turn to do the cooking and the dishes, so it was easier to eat out. I also was able to afford the local brew, Soul Brew. I was able to get it in abundance because it was affordable to me. This is how this chili bin was built in Solomon's. I could easily hold 2 dozen cans of Soul Brew in one session, but there was also room for sashimi, lobster tails, and then of course rice as the kinaki. Of course, that is bodybuilding. However, one Monday night in mid-October 2019, while at a restaurant with friends, filling my chili bin, I had a splitting headache like I'd never had before. I didn't think much of it at the time. I thought, well, we've had these before after a night on Soul Brew. I'll just sleep it off and I'll be good again. However, the next morning, I wasn't in a good way. Ma took me to see our GP. She didn't know what was wrong either. Although after a preliminary malaria test, it showed it could be positive, but it wasn't confirmed. Later that day, Ma had to call the doctor again because I was unresponsive, out the monkey, KO, didn't know what was happening. The doctor arrived, immediately called the ambulance. I was told later that I had spent 4 days in hospital in Honiara in a comatose state. I didn't know what was happening, what they were doing to me. While in hospital, I'm told, my Samoan, Tongan, Fijian, Malaysian, Solomon, Tuvalu friends all came to the hospital to assist. If we think that our hospital here is no good, I tell you, it's better than what you get in the Solomons. So I was really grateful that all my friends had come to assist. So if you guys are watching a live stream, thank you to Maso Geta, look at me more. By the way, Sister Mata Iroa, we all know her from a few months back. She was in Honiara at the time. I think she might have been there for soccer or something. Anyways, she was visiting the hospital and the nurses were struggling to put the drip in. Too many muscles, they couldn't find where the veins were. So Mata came along. In no time, she was able to find the vein, put the drip in, and we were good to go. That's the first point to remember. We'll get to it towards the end. On the Sunday afternoon, after being in a comatose state for about 4 or 5 days, Sunday afternoon, I regained conscious. There were doctors and nurses around mumbling something I didn't really understand. Then I heard this, "Hey, you dumb A, are you okay?" It was Raywin, my daughter. So I knew then that I wasn't still in Honiara because Raywin wasn't really a fan of Solomon's. I later found out that I had been air freighted to New Zealand directly to Auckland from Honiara on an air ambulance, that the FFA, the people I was working for, had organized through an insurance company. I recommend if you don't have health insurance, go and get it. Of course, arriving in Auckland, I was taken straight to Middlemore Hospital. They did a CT scan, and then I was immediately transferred to Auckland Hospital and underwent surgery to remove clotting from inside the skull, between the skull and the brain. It was probably just in the skull. There isn't much of a brain there. The idea was to remove whatever blood that was in there and also to find where I was bleeding from. Remembering back to the warfarin that I take, it prevents the blood from clotting. So this thing just kept bleeding. I later found out that our brother Tai and family and others had been praying for my recovery. another point to remember. Again, I didn't deserve it because I was in hospital. Being in hospital was self-inflicted. Overindulgence in beer, falling over, not knowing that the effects of the warfarin, the anti-clotting medicine, medication, had kicked in and I was bleeding inside. It may have been a possible positive for malaria, but it was still a disaster waiting to happen. I thank God for a good and supportive wife. It's the only time in my mind that stubborn is good. If she wasn't stubborn, she would have stopped. But because she was stubborn, she didn't stop. So then on the 30th of January this year, I accepted Jesus into my life. Was baptized in the pristine waters at Vayakura. I thank Jesus for opening my eyes, because although I could see, I didn't actually know what I was looking at. I also thank Jesus for opening my ears, because although I could hear, I wasn't listening. And as I said at the start, God really does work in mysterious ways. So if you go back to the points to remember that I highlighted, Sister Mata Iroa was in Solomon's 2019. She came to the Crusades last year, early this year. My family praying for my recovery. And then also having a stubborn wife that wouldn't give up. So having had the opportunity to be baptized, come to the church, come to services, go to our home group, I'm starting to unravel everything that was already sitting right in front of my eyes. Again, things that were there that I couldn't see. And now I'm starting to hear things because I'm starting to listen. So if I may use the prayer request from our daily bread this morning. Those that read it. Father, I'm sorry if I have taken your mercy and love for granted. Thank you for this wonderful gift and privilege that I don't deserve, yet you promised it unconditionally. Amen. Ma wanted to say thank you very much for your patience.
Hallelujah. Oh, give a hand of praise to God. Brother Peter, hallelujah. Oh, they deserve a standing ovation. Come on, give a hand of praise. That's a miracle over and beyond. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Tao will play another video while we prepare for our message. If you want to go to the restroom and relieve yourself or have a little bit of stretch up, when the message comes, bear in mind you don't walk away on God's word. So get yourself a break and relieve, hallelujah, with this praise song. Hallelujah. Thank you. Play by.
Let's go.
Those who didn't pick up and understand what Peter was trying to do, to say the brain is around that corner and the body is still trying to catch up. Hallelujah. I just saw Junior Manuela, the youth gone, and the body was trying to catch up. Hallelujah. The youth already gone, he's following to try to catch up. Hallelujah. That's the illustration. Hallelujah. I hope it's not too far down. Hallelujah. Mama better come. Without further ado, my pleasure to call up to the front our dear, beautiful, pretty daughter, Brianna. Hallelujah. Boy, Auri, come receive your certificate. Baptism. Hallelujah. God bless you. Bless you, baby. Thank you, Jesus. Love you, love you, love you, love you. Hallelujah. Lamentation says it is good to take up the yoke while you are young. Take up the calling in Jesus while you are young. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Most of us picked it up when the youthful age gone. The energy, the vitality gone. Hallelujah. We took it up at our almost sunset time. Too late. Hallelujah. That's what the scripture is trying to say. Now, Brother Joshua Waru. Hallelujah. All the way. Oh, Karakara. God bless you, son. Hallelujah. Okay, come on, come away. Hallelujah. Next time, tell your whole group they have to say their memory verse with you. Hey, not copy you. All right, thank you. Okay. Without further ado, saints, thank you for our focus and attention on Jesus. Our pleasure to call up to the pulpit to bring us the word of God, our dear son, Alex. Hallelujah. Put our hands together. Amen. Acknowledging Mama Aggie with us today. Hallelujah. And a quick reminder before it slip off. Hallelujah. Last notice this morning was no hugging, no kissing, and no whatever else, contact. Hallelujah. Okay, just a hand extension to each other. This is a drill exercise. Imagine this warning came when there's a COVID in the country. Then we'll be asking, calling, come train us, come show us how. So we've been given the privilege to exercise. And should disaster hit, we know exactly what to do. Can we say amen? So don't go say anything negative, anything gossipy about what they be unique. We show the difference because we're the children of the light. Hallelujah. God bless us all. Be blessed. Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord, saints. I give glory and honor to God for this blessed opportunity to be able to speak His word for today. So for us today, I bring to you nothing but the simple truth. Amen. Although simple, it is the difference between life and death. It is the difference whether or not you are going to make it to heaven or not. Amen. So I stand only as a messenger. I can tell you what to do, how to do it, but you have to do it yourself. Amen. So I praise God for this opportunity. Without further ado, Acts chapter 2, verses 38. It reads, "Then Peter said unto them, Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost." Amen. While reading through Acts, I came across something that just blew my mind. When Peter preached his first sermon, you know why the cross is so unpopular today? Because the cross tells you, you are wrong. Amen. So that's why people are not ready to come to Jesus, because they are not ready to humble themselves, to repent, to admit that they were wrong. So Peter told them, you know that man you put the nails through the hands and the legs? The man you drove the spear, the man you whipped, that was the Son of God. And they were filled with guilt, and they were pricked in their heart. And they asked Peter, men and brethren, what shall we do?
How can we get rid of this sin? How can we reconnect ourselves with God? And he said, repent, be baptized, and be filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen. Our theme for today is steps to heaven. Steps to salvation. Amen. So the way to get God's attention is repentance. The Bible states that there is great rejoicing over one sinner that repents. Host of angels rejoice over one sinner that repents. Heaven rejoices for this one sinner because this is someone giving their life to be born again. This is someone receiving salvation. This is someone ready to receive Jesus in their life. Saints, it's a surrendering process that allows God to take control of their life. That is why King David was known as the man after God's heart. Because whenever he sinned, he repented. Amen? Whenever he sinned, he surrendered himself. He took off his crown, his robe, and he cried before God. Repentance. Amen? God responds to repentance. So many people believe that they don't have to go to church to be saved. Others believe that they don't have to get baptized to be saved. If this was how salvation was really done, then why do we still have to come to church? Why do we have to get baptized? Why can't I just say that I believe and I'll be saved? While like everything else in the world, God has assigned steps to salvation. So for example, to get into university, students have to first go to school, study, sit exams, and pass the required grades for that particular university. Their scores will determine whether they will be taken in or not. Those are the steps to getting into uni. Or obtaining a driver's license, there are steps to getting this, but you have got to pass the test first. The same is with salvation. God has assigned steps to salvation for us today. It starts off with repentance, then comes baptism, and then the infilling of the Holy Spirit. If we were like the many in the world who only need to believe to be saved, then automatically we have failed. If we were like the many in the world who didn't need to get baptized to be saved, then again, we have failed. If we were like the many who believe that church will not save us, then we have failed again because we have not fulfilled God's steps to salvation. Acts 2:38, repent, be baptized, every one of you. Not just some of you, not just those who want to, but everyone in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. So, getting into heaven is like a student trying to get into Otago University or Harvard or Auckland Uni. There is a way to get there, but unlike the schools, your mom cannot get you into heaven with the many connections she may have. Your dad cannot get you into heaven, no matter how rich and famous he may be. Your friend cannot get you into heaven just because his dad is the head of the school. No, salvation is individual, meaning you have to do it on your own. But you know what? You are not really done. The moment you make the decision to surrender your life to Christ, Jesus steps in to guide you because he knows how the devil will react. So he steps in to guide you through your steps to salvation. When we look around the world today, we see so much chaos. There's so much fighting, so much pain, people dying because of a pandemic. What makes it more sad is that some more, maybe most of them died without taking these steps. They died without repentance, without baptism, and without the seal of God, which is the Holy Ghost, which ensures our salvation with God. The world is dying rapidly, and as you can see today, our worship has changed because of one suspected case on the island. In a world full of uncertainty, a world full of death, a world full of deadly diseases, are you 100% sure you're saved? Are you certain you have fulfilled God's steps into salvation? Have you repented? Have you been baptized? Do you have the seal of the Holy Ghost? If you've answered no to any of those questions, then you need to complete those steps. You need to take these steps to be saved. What do you have to lose? Repent, be baptized, and be filled with the Holy Spirit is all it takes. One and three cannot go without two. Two and three cannot go without one. One, two, three steps is all it takes to salvation. So So I urge you to take those steps today. I urge you to take the step to Jesus. May the Lord bless us all and continue to keep us COVID-free. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for that very simple, straightforward, grade one lesson, grade one. Not even college level. Thank you, Jesus. All right. Anybody who wishes to be blessed to come up and be prayed for, you can play this space. Hallelujah. Make your space in. Elders come, lay hands and anoint and pray for you. Hallelujah. Shall we stand to our feet while the song is being played? Hallelujah. And just stand still where you are and allow the people to come. Hallelujah. What you're simply doing is, Lord, I honor you for a soul to be saved. I honor you to have somebody receive the miracle. I rise up for my brother, for my sister, who need the anointing and the divine touch of Jesus. So I stand on their behalf in faith for the release of that miracle in Jesus' name. Amen. Because once upon a time, somebody stood for me. Hallelujah. Thank you. Play that music. Anybody? Bye.
You will need to guide me.
Anybody?
Lord, I do believe.
Thank you. Thank you, Elvis. Anybody? Stand by. Hallelujah. Those watching on live stream, you can take a step of faith. It takes a step of faith. Everyone who received their miracle, they took a step of faith to touch the hem of his garment, to rise up to their feet. You too can rise up with a step of faith. We will lead you through a prayer to touch the garment of Jesus. Hallelujah. Through faith and be healed and delivered and be saved in Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Joining the youth so they can be our contribution to our youth ministry. We're a body of Christ. Hallelujah. We're not separated. We're not isolated. We're a body, each one member of it. Over there, the other who is, come on, come right up here. It's a gap away, don't get cluttered together. How are you? Come on, Adlos, Adetaro, go to the next. Give it all, I will go. Elders, don't stay too long. Short, move to the next and to the next. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you. We have a candidate for a water baptism right now. Take her through. Give Jesus a hand, praise.
You can only have
thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. You may be seated. Hallelujah. Thank you for praying. Thank you for honoring those people who've come up for a special prayer. Hallelujah. We have a candidate getting dressed, ready to go through the watery grave. While we are waiting, hallelujah, let me call our mother from Aitutaki, Janine Moeroru, to come and speak to us. Come over here. Hallelujah. I want to give a right hand of fellowship of congratulations. Hallelujah. Doing spiritual warfare every Thursday night without letting off. Why? Because we ignited and made them move. So it caused a rippling effect, a domino effect. Hitting Maya and Aitutaki, and Aitutaki is still continuing. That's why I'm encouraging us. Don't quench the spirit. Do your own work. I hear Chichikawa Chikiokiakapu'au is doing this as well. No big asking. It's just within your territory, your jurisdiction. Just a short walk around, binding. Binding, there are spiritual, demonic, evil forces in the air, floating, waiting to take somebody down. It could well be you. That's why the truth people are needed to rise up to the occasion and be counted as a warrior for Jesus. Hallelujah. Not just too busy for the world and less busy for Jesus. Hallelujah. Mama, thank you for joining us. Glory to Jesus. Hallelujah. Here. Hoi.
Praise the Lord, saints. Truly God is good. You know, I want to thank you. Thank you, Bishop and Mama Pere and all the saints of God that have, as the Bishop has said, has done the ripple effect. It started from the Tatira family. God bless their hearts. And they opened the doors for the rest of our island to come on board and conquer this. Conquer the claim victory in Jesus' name upon all these demonic spirits that are holding our people and have put a barrier between the people and God. So we open those doors and we have received that blessing in Jesus' name. And it has spiritually moved within our saints. You can see now the difference between each and every one of them. You know, they've grown so much and they're always going up higher heights for Jesus. So I want to thank you. I want to give honor to God for you, Bishop, and also our mother and all your elders and all the saints of the Most High God. I give the love of our pastor, Pastor Moeroru, and all the saints in Aitutaki who continue to watch you and to grow and to learn of the saints. So I want to thank God and truly bless each and every one of you. Amen.
Thank you. We're ready. Thank you to God. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, John, Elder John Teo in his full suit. Hallelujah. I think the one who's wearing the fishing, what you call suit, right? But the nail's probably too sharp and picked a hole in the suit. Must be a sharp nail, eh? Oh, with put out today the suit, Papa Chut. Hallelujah. Maybe I put it. Sister Inami Tupa, by the confession of your faith in our Lord and Savior Jesus, your obedience, your trust, your faith, your confidence in his death, burial, and resurrection, we now baptize you according to Holy Scripture in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. Amen. Oh, bless you, Leilani. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Yeah. Now, hand clapping is singing for you. Hallelujah. Come sit with Bishop on the table. Hallelujah. And Mother Janine for lunch. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
says. All right, take it from the horse's mouth. There's no COVID case on Rarotonga. There's none. But some people came from a territory, Papatoetoe, accompanied the body to be buried. They were the concern. Hallelujah. So the New Zealand gave instruction. We always follow what New Zealand does. Hallelujah. Preventing, protecting ourselves. Just pray for those people to own up and go to the Maraiora to be squamped. Hallelujah. To test negative. Then we would all be pulled in like we are today. Disobedience. Hallelujah. Disobedience kills. Hallelujah. Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord, in Jesus' name, we thank you for your word that was preached today. We ask that your word be rooted within our hearts in Jesus' name, and that we bear fruit in a thousandfold. Lord, dismiss us with your blessings, love and care in Jesus' name. All God's people say, amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be upon us all, both now and forever. In Jesus' name, all of God's people say, amen. Amen. Amen.
Oh, yeah. This is right here.
Everybody, pay your bill, then be ready to be served.